Yeah, without reaching for it. No. I just told you, don't reach for it.
Stop! Stop! Stop!
In the blink of an eye, a normal day for a police officer can turn into an extraordinary tale of courage and danger. From nerve-wracking high-speed pursuits to intense gun battles, these stories aren't just about law enforcement. They're about survival, split-second decisions, and unimaginable bravery. These are the untold, gripping accounts of officers who found themselves in life-threatening situations, where every move could be the difference between life and death. Join us as we explore some of the craziest police shootings where officers face more than just criminals. Number 7. Unexpected Turn. On March 12, 2019, what began as a typical day in the life of Officer Jane Smith quickly spiraled into a scenario straight out of an action movie. It started with a routine traffic stop on a quiet suburban street in Columbus, Ohio. The car, a red sedan with tinted windows, had a broken taillight, nothing out of the ordinary. But as Officer Smith approached, the tension in the air was noticeable. The driver, later identified as Michael Johnson, a 34-year-old with a history of minor offenses, seemed unnervingly calm. Officer Smith, sensing something amiss, asked for the usual documents. Johnson's response was anything but usual. With a sudden burst of speed, he slammed the gas pedal, turning a simple stop into a high-speed chase, piercing through the busy streets at speeds hitting 90 miles per hour. The pursuit wasn't just a desperate bid for freedom, it was a calculated move. Johnson, it turned out, was wanted for a string of armed robberies across the state. His calm demeanor hid a desperate man, cornered and dangerous. The chase continued for a nerve-wracking 20 minutes, with multiple police cars joining the pursuit. Radio calls were made. Strategies quickly formed as the Columbus Police Department coordinated to bring the situation under control without risking civilian lives. The chase came to a dramatic end when Johnson's car skidded on a sharp turn, crashing into a roadside barrier. But the danger was far from over. As officers approached, Johnson, trapped and with nothing to lose, opened fire. What followed was a brief but intense exchange of gunfire. Miraculously, no one was injured. The incident ended with Johnson's arrest, but the echoes of those gunshots lingered in the community. In the aftermath, the Columbus Police Department was commended for their handling of the situation. Their quick response and strategic approach possibly saved lives, including Johnson's. This incident highlighted the unpredictability and peril that officers face daily, turning routine into life-threatening in mere seconds. Number 6. The Standoff.
Some breaking news now at 4:54, an update. We shared this with you a moment ago. This is the live scene now in Aurora. Police tell us now they're working a standoff situation. So this is the intersection of Maxwell and Helena. As we get more information, learn more, we'll bring it to you. But they do tell us it's now a standoff situation.
On August 4th, 2020, the Denver Police Department faced a drastically different challenge. A call came in at 7:30 a.m. about an armed man barricaded inside a downtown apartment building. The suspect, 39-year-old Alex Martinez, a known figure to law enforcement due to prior misdemeanors, had escalated to a dangerous level. Martinez, holed up in his third-floor apartment, was not just a threat to himself but to the entire neighborhood. He had a shotgun and was visibly agitated, shouting threats and warnings out of his window. The police knew this wasn't going to be a swift arrest. It required patience, strategy, and a deep understanding of human psychology. Negotiators were called in, setting the stage for a painstakingly delicate operation. They started a dialogue, attempting to reach through Martinez's cloud of anger and fear. Outside, the streets were closed off and residents evacuated. While inside, negotiators worked tirelessly, trying to forge a connection, to find a sliver of trust. Hours ticked by. The tension was high. But then, a breakthrough. Martinez, responding to the negotiator's persistent and empathetic communication, agreed to surrender. Weapons were laid down, and he stepped out, ending the standoff without a single shot fired. The impact of this incident resonated deeply within the Denver community. This event highlighted the importance of negotiation skills and psychological insight in modern policing. Number 5. Hostage Shootout. A harrowing incident unfolded in Atlanta, Georgia, on the chilly morning of November 15, 2021. In a quiet suburban neighborhood, a distress call reported a hostage situation. A 45-year-old man, Derek Thompson, with a known history of mental instability and violent tendencies, had taken his own family hostage. As the Atlanta Police Department's SWAT team encircled the house, the stakes were sky high. Inside were Thompson's wife and two children, their lives hanging in the balance. The challenge was not just to apprehend Thompson, but to ensure the hostages emerged unscathed. It was a delicate dance between aggressive action and cautious strategy. Negotiators tried to establish communication, but Thompson was beyond reason. He fired shots through a window, a clear signal that this wasn't going to end peacefully. Tensions escalated rapidly. The SWAT team, trained for such high-stress situations, had to make a split-second decision. They stormed the house, a tactical move filled with risks.
Shots fired, shots fired.
Three Georgia officers.
About the first entry.
Dramatic body cam video capturing the moment Officer Taylor Webb is shot. A hail of gunfire. SWAT Officer Keegan Merritt shot in the hand.
I'm here.
Dragging himself to safety. A bullet shatters a window where this officer was just standing.
Gunfire erupted, echoing through the neighborhood. Amidst the chaos, the team had to maintain a razor-sharp focus. Any misstep could result in tragedy. After minutes that felt like hours, the team secured the area. The hostages were safe, miraculously unharmed, and Thompson was subdued. The psychological toll on the officers, always having to be prepared for the worst while hoping for the best, was immense. For the community, it was a wake-up call to the realities of mental health crises. The Atlanta Police Department's swift and strategic response not only saved lives, but also underscored the critical need for tactical preparedness in modern policing. Number 4. Undercover Operation. Our next story unfolds on the streets of Chicago, late in the evening of April 10, 2022. An undercover operation, meticulously planned, was set into motion with the aim of infiltrating a notorious drug ring. The central figure was Detective Sarah Lopez, a seasoned officer known for her sharp instincts and deep commitment to her work. The operation had been months in the making, with Lopez slowly earning the trust of the drug ring's members. The endgame was to organize a sting operation to capture the kingpin, a task filled with danger, given the unpredictability and violence associated with drug cartels. As the night of the sting operation arrived, tension was in the air. The meeting point was an abandoned warehouse. Lopez, wired for sound, stepped into the lion's den. But as the deal was about to be sealed, something went horribly wrong. One of the cartel members, suspicious of Lopez's identity, drew a gun. In a split second, the operation turned from a secret mission into a full-blown shootout. Backup units, hidden nearby, rushed in, amidst a hail of bullets. The scene was chaotic, with officers having to differentiate friend from foe in a matter of milliseconds. When the dust settled, several cartel members were arrested, but at a cost. Lopez sustained a non-fatal gunshot wound. It was a lesson in the importance of meticulous planning and the need for quick decision-making under pressure. For the Chicago Police Department, it reinforced the need for constant vigilance and the reality that, in the world of undercover operations, nothing is ever certain until it's over. Number 3. Crowded Area. On a bustling Saturday afternoon, May 22, 2023, the streets of downtown Los Angeles transformed from a vibrant hub of weekend activity to a scene of chaos and fear.
News out of downtown LA. There's been a shooting outside a liquor store, but it has taken a bizarre and even more dangerous turn.
Officer Brian O'Connor and his partner were patrolling the area when a routine call escalated into a crisis. A man, later identified as 28-year-old Marcus Green, had begun shooting indiscriminately near a crowded outdoor market. The officers were on the scene within minutes, but they faced a daunting task. The area was packed with people, families enjoying their weekend, unaware of the impending danger. With every shot fired by Green, the risk of civilian casualties rose exponentially. O'Connor and his partner had to think and act fast. They needed to neutralize the threat without causing further harm to the scores of innocent bystanders caught in the crossfire. Communication and coordination were key. O'Connor's partner relayed information to the responding units while O'Connor focused on locating Green. As Green moved through the crowd, his actions were unpredictable and erratic. O'Connor, using his training and instincts, navigated through the panicked crowd, trying to get a clear line of sight. His priority was clear: stop Green before more lives were put at risk. Finally, O'Connor found his moment. With a clear shot and no civilians in the line of fire, he took the shot, successfully incapacitating Green. The ordeal was over, but the impact of those terrifying moments lingered. Quick, strategic decision-making and an acute awareness of the surroundings were crucial in preventing a bad situation from turning into a catastrophe. For O'Connor and his team, it was a reminder of their responsibility to protect and serve, even in the most chaotic and unpredictable circumstances. Number 2. Domestic disturbance. In the quiet suburbs of Miami on June 18, 2023, a call came in at 10 p.m. about a domestic altercation. Officers Maria Gonzalez and John Davis responded, expecting a routine dispute resolution. What they encountered was far from routine. Upon arrival, they were met with the sounds of shouting and objects being thrown inside the house. The officers announced their presence, but the door remained closed. Concerned for the safety of those inside, they made the decision to enter. The scene inside was chaotic. Furniture overturned, and in the center of it all, a visibly agitated man, Robert Evans, in a heated argument with his partner. Evans, upon seeing the officers, became even more agitated. Unknown to Gonzalez and Davis, he had a concealed handgun. As they tried to defuse the situation, Evans drew his weapon, and without warning, shots rang out. The officers, caught off guard, had to quickly switch gears from negotiators to taking defensive action. Gonzalez found cover behind a sofa, while Davis returned fire, trying to neutralize the threat without harming the other occupants of the house. Their training in dealing with volatile situations was put to the test. Every decision, every movement was crucial. After a tense few minutes, Evans was subdued. The relief was huge, but so was the realization of how quickly a domestic call can escalate into a life-threatening situation. It was a situation that required not just tactical skill, but also an understanding of human behavior under extreme stress. The psychological impact of such incidents on officers is profound, highlighting the multifaceted challenges they face in their duty to serve and protect. Number 1. The raid.
New details tonight about a drug raid that went sideways, ending with four narcotics officers being shot in Houston. Tonight, the police union president called the suspects dirtbags and said police are tired of having targets on their backs. Reporter Chris Martinez on how the shootout unfolded.
On the early morning of September 30th, 2023, in Houston, Texas, a meticulously planned police raid took a sudden and violent turn. The Houston SWAT team, led by Sergeant Lucas Martinez, was tasked with executing a high-risk warrant at a known drug den, a hub for narcotics distribution with a reputation for harboring armed criminals. At 5 a.m., the team, dressed in tactical gear and armed with breaching tools and firearms, approached the target location. Every member was acutely aware of the risks involved in such operations. The element of surprise was their greatest asset. The plan was to enter swiftly, secure the premises, and arrest the suspects with minimal confrontation. However, as the team breached the door, they were met with an unexpected barrage of gunfire. The suspects inside were not just armed, but seemingly prepared for a confrontation. Sergeant Martinez and his team were forced into a firefight, a situation they trained for but hoped to avoid. Bullets flew through the narrow hallways, the sound deafening, the danger imminent. In the midst of chaos, the team's training kicked in. They moved with precision, using tactical formations and covering fire to advance. The primary goal was to neutralize the threat while preventing harm to uninvolved occupants and neighbors. The exchange of gunfire lasted for what felt like an eternity, but was only a few minutes. Eventually, the SWAT team gained control of the situation. The suspects were arrested, and miraculously, there were no fatalities. For Sergeant Martinez and his team, it was a day that underscored the importance of their rigorous training and the reality that even the best laid plans can go awry in the face of unexpected resistance. In the world of policing, every day brings a new challenge, a new risk. These stories are a glimpse into the bravery and quick thinking of those who protect us. But it begs the question, in the face of such danger, what would you do? Thanks for watching. Please comment, like, and subscribe so you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. See you on the next one.